maybe this is one of the songs that was written that was, you know, for just him, you know?
Well, you, I'm wondering if there are any covers that anybody put out that.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm guess I'm curious too, because you know why? Because it's one of those songs that's just kind of, it's like an open highway, you know, it's just very kind of, it just allows him just to get in there. It's a vehicle for his voice and just, you know, just belting it out. You know, the words are also kind of very interesting, you know, really, you know, basically kind of about, you know, believing in himself, you know, distractions in his life, people around him, you know, he's going to separate himself from all that noise and, like, you know, maybe, you know, negative, you know, people, you know, things in his life, you know, he needs to get away from that. And like, he is the highway, you know, and he's like, I am the highway. I am not your carpet ride. I am the sky, you know, sky's the limit, sky.
Hey, welcome back to Into the Music. I'm Chris. I'm here with my buddy, Greg. And Greg, you got something for me to react to? So lay it on me.
Okay, I'm going to lay on you some Audioslave.
Audioslave, okay.
Have you heard of that?
I know of them.
Yeah, they're like,
I've heard a couple songs.
They were so-called supergroup some while back. Yeah, so I'm not going to say any names. Leave that for the other side because you never give me anything. Not one iota. But I will give you the name of the song, though. That might actually help.
You like when I give you some information.
Oh, I love. Yeah, so, sure.
Okay.
Yeah.
You're right. I should do that.
So anyway, so I Am the Highway. That's the name of the song.
Okay.
By Audioslave. I gave you the link somewhere. Go check it out.
I Am the Highway. I might have heard this.
Oh.
But if I did, it's only like real quick in passing. Because I never dove into any of this stuff, really.
So the name of the song.
As much as I've meant to, because I really like Tom Morello's guitar playing. So
yeah.
That's why I want to get more into this band.
Well, now you mentioned name.
Give it a shot.
And Chris Cornell singing. Yeah, crazy.
And
he's from Soundgarden.
Okay.
Yeah. So, okay. Yeah. Yeah. All right, cool. Go check it out.
Yeah, I got information out of you anyway.
I know. How the hell did you do that? You're good.
My wily ways.
You.
All right. Let me listen. All right, man. What a great song. This is really good.
Hey, man.
Hey.
See you back. And you took the highway. Did you take the highway?
Well, I am the highway.
You are the highway, yeah.
I am the highway. Yeah, I'm feeling kind of run down.
And you know what? I'm not your rolling wheels, too. So there you go.
Okay. All right.
All right, now that we got that out of the way.
Now you've established that.
What did you think of the song? And wait, did you know it?
I had heard this one, but I didn't really pay much attention to it when I did. I know I liked it when I first heard it,
okay.
But I never went back to it. So this was good. This got me to actually listen closely, or more closely, let's say.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think it's great. This guy's voice is just, you know, probably some people don't like it, just like the way I am about certain singers. You know, you might have noticed that. But he's such a powerful voice. And the song itself was really good. It's a really good song. I'm definitely going to put this on some playlists. And it's kind of understated in a way, other than his voice being very powerful. Like, I was expecting Tom Morello to just kind of blast away at something or do something really crazy.
I know.
He didn't, but it was very tasty playing.
Boy, man, you covered all the bases that I actually had in the song that I was going to go.
What video now, right?
Yeah, we said it just recently too. One of
like that ever happens
yet,
with us.
Somehow that went like 24 minutes.
I think our shortest video is probably like, I think one time we did like 11 minutes.
I think just recently it was 11 minutes.
For a minute and a half song.
I think it was Joe Jackson, you know? And actually that conversation was really good. Yeah. Anyway.
Left it in with not having the time, right? Because that was the theme.
Yeah, right. We were talking, the big clocks. I'm like, we got to go, you know? But here's the thing. Where do I go? Because you dropped all these nuggets all over the place. So like stuff I was going to cover. So let me actually start off. Again, supergroup, Audioslave, that's what Wiki is saying. I think I agree, right? Tom Morello, Radom, Rage Against the Machine. You know, we talked about Chris Cornell and Soundgarden. This song was released in 2003 as the fourth single from, I believe, it's their one and only album called Audioslave.
Oh, they only got one, huh?
I could be wrong, but like looking at Wiki, it was kind of weird how they were identifying it. And they were like, there was no other like list of albums or whatever. So okay. I think so. Let's see. This song was used in the 2019 memorial concert, you know, when he passed away. And he died in 2017 at the age of 52. Mm-hmm. He was about 2 or 3 months shy of his 53rd birthday. He had been, so we talked about Soundgarden. He's also known for 4 solo albums, 16 Grammy Award nominations, winning 3 of them, and voted by Guitar World magazine as rock's greatest singer by the readers of that magazine. Mm-hmm. So, you know, just a real, you know, well-known, successful rock.
Wasn't he with Temple of the Dog, which was that project with,
you know,
Jam too?
I think you might be right on that.
Yeah.
So I think I missed to actually include that. Yeah.
I think he did it saying Hunger Strike, right? I think that's the name of the song.
I think so. Yeah. 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 Okay. Look
at that.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's got that distinctive voice.
Well, yes. Yeah. I know. He struggled with depression most of his life and he had passed away only hours after performing at a Soundgarden concert. He had left the band Soundgarden some years back. And then, like I said, you know, I think that band you just mentioned, and also this one, and again, solo stuff or like that. So, but I think he wound up kind of going back to them. I don't know if that band, in the last days of his life, you know, if that was, you know, the same band members, all of them, you know, from when it first formed, who knows, but yeah. And you know, the thing about his voice is that I remember when Soundgarden first came out, and it was like, maybe it was just so powerful, maybe it was too much, I don't know, you know, I recognized it as being an amazing voice, but I don't know if it was their music in the beginning, I don't know, you know. Black Hole Sun is like their biggest song. I know. I remember not liking that at first, you know.
Well, it was a very heavy sound.
It's a very heavy sound.
So while it might be good, you might not be in the mood for it sometimes.
Well, I got to tell you, man, recently, maybe it's after his passing, but, you know, that comes on and at the end where it just kind of repeats over and it just takes out. I just, I'm like, don't stop. You know, so I actually have really grown to love the song. Mm-hmm. And I've really grown to love his voice. And, you know, maybe as years went on, he knew how to use his voice maybe more strategically, if that's not the what, like, you know, more wisely, you know, maybe not always pressing the gas pedal down, you know, 100 miles, maybe, you know, I think he learned to kind of use his voice and maybe more effectively. You know, I'm sure some kind of fans are going to be throwing stuff at me right now, but just an amazing voice. All I can say is that I really appreciate his voice now than ever before. I mean, over the last several years. So like when this song, you know, I had heard this song, I was kind of almost like you, you know, I had known this song, but then it kind of came across again recently. And I just remember just giving it a listen, you know, and I just fell in love with it. And, you know, you were talking about his voice for the song. I don't know if anyone else really could have sang this song and really succeeded with it like, you know, Chris did. You know, I think maybe this is one of the songs that was written that was, you know, for just him, you know.
Well, I'm wondering if there are any covers that anybody put out that.
Yeah, I don't know. I guess I'm curious too, because you know why? Because it's one of those songs that's just kind of, it's like an open highway, you know, it's just very kind of, it just allows him just to get in there. It's a vehicle for his voice and just, you know, just belting it out. You know, the words are also kind of very interesting, you know, really, you know, basically kind of about, you know, believing in himself, you know, distractions in his life, people around him, you know, he's going to separate himself from all that noise and, like, you know, maybe, you know, negative, you know, people, you know, things in his life, you know, he needs to get away from that. And like, he is the highway, you know, and he's like, I am the highway. I am not your carpet ride. I am the sky, you know, sky's the limit, sky. I mean, and I think something else too, friends and liars, don't wait for me because I'll get on all by myself. I put millions of miles under my heels and still too close to you, I feel. Some actually feel that he wrote the song about his divorce from his wife, while others feel that he wrote it about his leaving Soundgarden.
So, what does he say? Does he say?
I didn't dive that deep to find out, to try to get quotes from him. But
So he wrote the song?
I believe he wrote the song, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. So yeah, man. And then you mentioned about Morella, right? Mm-hmm. Because that's the one, I mean, musically, that's the one curious thing about the song is that musical bridge. You know, you're ready, like you're like, you know, you kind of strapped in your chair, you know, you're ready for it. And it was like subdued, like big time subdued.
I like that it was. It all fit, right?
I like it. I mean, it is what it is. It's part of the song. Yeah. So
unless you were truly, it killed your expectations.
I think I you know, maybe he didn't have time to really come up with something. I don't really know.
Yeah, they were like, on a deadline.
Like, there's a schedule here. We gotta get done. I don't have anything. All right, just go do. I don't know. I think it could have used something. I'm not complaining. It's a beautiful song. I love it, you know? And in a way, I guess, you know, when you get thrown like that, you know, sometimes that, you know, that it's like, you know, the ending of Sopranos, you know, like, you know, really? They just had to cut out. That's it.
You know, that was almost a great ending.
Well, some people think that it's not, although I think it's grown on people over the years, you know, and I think just like this song, you know, I'm just a little surprised.
Now I want to talk about the Sopranos.
Yeah, I'm just surprised that.
Well,
Morella,
you know why it went to black, right?
Yeah, because there's theory that, you know, he got wiped out. Yeah, that they killed.
Yeah, so that's
brilliant. But then some will argue the other thing that, you know, they're fine, you know, and
I think David Chase actually said, yeah, they got killed. It makes sense.
He's never said it.
Okay. All right. I'm not going to argue any further. Then we'll have to start another channel.
Yeah. Well, actually,
The Sopranos.
Two guys are doing that right now on a podcast.
I know. It's actually pretty good. What is it? Talking Sopranos?
Talking Sopranos. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I love that. But I'm not actually doing anything with this, you know, and when not working and not being a dad and not being a husband, I'm checking out that podcast. It's really cool. But yeah, anything else
to say? You got to do something for yourself once in a while, right?
Yeah, absolutely. But yeah, so anything else to say about the song?
No, just that it's going to go on a playlist and I'll be listening to it again.
Oh, and I think on the other side, I had said like why I was kind of picking a song now. It just with our recent sort of Deftones, and we kind of make more of a move into like the heavier sound. Yeah. And
well, that combined with some people had mentioned Audioslave on the comments.
Yeah.
So yeah.
Yeah. And so
we're going in all kinds of directions.
Well, here's the thing, Chris, right? Because I mentioned in some episodes this radio station that is playing when I'm bringing my kids back and forth to school. You know, it really exists, and it's a hard rock station, and I don't always put it on all the time.
What's but the really, station?
Oh my God, it's 94.3. If you're here, actually, that where matter. I am, 94. Yeah. I can't tell you. Well, because that station's changed so many, you know, names, but it's 94.3. And it's like a heavier rock sound, right? And so if I'm not listening to 92.9, you know, like more progressive, then I'm listening to that. And just the other day, you know, this song came on. I was like, oh my God, I haven't heard this song in a long time. And then I was like, you know, when I got back home, I just dove into it. I'm like, this kind of fits with like where we're going with the heavier sound. And it was just a beautiful song. So just yeah. Timing, you know, they say timing is everything. Well, yeah, so, all right, cool. So I'm going to take us out.
Okay.
And I'm going to say, everyone out there, you know, wow, I really hope that you guys enjoy this. The gals and the guys enjoyed this episode. If you liked it, hit the like button and sub or don't sub or whatever. But just glad that you're with us today. And Chris, have a great night. And we'll see everyone else on the next episode of Into the Music.